Hey, this is Ralph, and in this video, I want to quickly show you how you can start your first Word document, save it, print it, share it. Okay, so you need to have Microsoft Word installed. And remember, if you're a COCC student, you get free access to Microsoft Word and the other Microsoft Office programs, which you can install. And this is different and better than the Office 365 web-based versions. Web-based version is nice, but you're going to get more features with the installed version, and that's for Windows or Mac users. Okay, so I've already got Microsoft Word installed, and I'm going to go ahead and launch that on my computer here, so I can just do a search for Word and find it that way. And when you start up Word, you're going to get this interface where you get some choices up at the top. I almost always start off with a blank document. Depending on the kind of project or document you're creating, maybe some of these templates, you know, might be useful to you. But otherwise, if you're not sure, go with blank. You know, in school, for the most part, going with a blank document is probably the safest way to go. I'm going to start off my blank document. Most people are already pretty familiar with Microsoft Word from other work, maybe the high school and stuff like that. Fortunately, the ribbons, you know, the ribbons across the top with all the commands. There's different tabs that you can jump on to take you over to those different areas. Ignore that school one. I just made that in another video. But basically, these will be the most popular commands that you can use with your document. And these should satisfy pretty much any need that you have. The home ribbon, probably the most popular, has the most common stuff that you're going to do. For instance, all the font controls are in there, and there's paragraph controls in there. And there are styles. A lot of students don't use styles, but I think it's good that they're there, and you should be using more styles in your document. Okay, so then it's just a matter of typing into your document. Do you set your font now or later? Doesn't matter. You could start off now and then change it later. For instance, I'm going to go ahead and quickly make a bunch of text on here. I'm just going to do equals, rand, 40 paragraphs, 8 sentences each. So now I've got a really big document, 8-page document, and maybe I find out now, oh crap, I'm using the wrong font for my class. I should be doing double spacing and all that kind of stuff. No worries. Just press Control A or Command A on your keyboard, select everything, and then of course you can change that font. Maybe I need to be using Times New Roman, maybe I need to be doing double spacing, stuff like that. Yeah, and that's all there is to it. So you make your document, and definitely you should be saving it regularly. There are autosave features available, but I have been burned on autosave before. So what I like to do is the very first time I save my document, doesn't matter if you do save or save as, the first time you save the document, make sure you know where you're saving it to so that you can find it easily. I have seen a number of students quickly save a document, especially during an exam situation. They save that document and then they can't find it very easily to turn it in, whether it's to email it or submit it in Blackboard or whatever. So you always need to know where you're saving to. For many students, it might default to your online school OneDrive account, and that may not be the most convenient thing that you need sometimes. I'm going to save instead to my desktop. Now, that's an option there. If it wasn't there, then I would click on Browse in the lower left, and I would go to my desktop on my computer. It's giving me a generic file name here. I'll just change that out to file name, and I'm going to save that to my desktop. I'm saving it to a location where I can easily find it later. Okay, now I've got that saved. How do I want to print this, or do I want to print it? Well, file, print will take care of that. And when you go into print, you're always going to get a print preview, so you can kind of see how this document's going to look when it prints. I don't have any page numbers or anything like that, so nothing fancy, but were you expecting page numbers? Now, this is interesting. I have a blank page at the end, so maybe that's something that I don't want to have. So what I could do is, all right, well, let me exit out of that print and let me go investigate that blank page, see what's going on down there. And sure enough, I've got a blank page. This happens a lot, but basically I can just click on that blank page. There's my little insertion point, press my backspace, gets rid of that. I just had an empty paragraph on there. So now I can resave using my quick access toolbar, file, print, and now I can look at that print preview. If I'm satisfied with that, then of course I choose my printer. I don't actually have a printer installed here, so I would have to print to PDF or one of these other options. but I choose my printer and click print, and there we go. Now, something else you can do while you're in this same dialog box, or you can go to File, and there are options for sharing. And I could save to the cloud, which could end up going to my OneDrive account, which is pretty nice if you have to work on it with a team. Or I can choose to email, and it'll quickly and easily email as an attachment, or I could convert this to a PDF. If I was working on a resume, this might be a good option here because it'll convert my document to a PDF and probably make it more universal for that recipient to open it. I'll click Send as Attachment, and that brings up my outgoing email. And it's already got the attachment in there. That's cool. And I can just put in the recipient, update the subject, my message, and move on from there. So pretty easy to do. Open a Word document, create your document, save it, and then share it with other users. And that could be email, or it could be saving to cloud storage or to your OneDrive account, something like that. Thanks for hanging out with me.